Hey, welcome. In today's video, you're going to discover how to do product research with Helium 10. And today I'm joined by Bradley Sutton from Helium 10. Bradley is Chief Brand Evangelist at Helium 10 and also Director of Training. And Bradley did over 400 product launches on Amazon, recently went to the Maldives to share some good insights about product launches with us and lots of other stuff. Probably you already know Bradley. And if not, Bradley, could you please introduce yourself to us, man? Good to have you here today.
Hey guys, my name is Bradley. I've been at Helium 10 for a little over a couple years now. And before then I was a consultant for Amazon sellers, and I'm the host of the most listened to podcast in the world for Amazon sellers, the Serious Sellers Podcast. It's great to be here in the Maldives with you guys.
Yeah, man, welcome again. It's the second time you're here with us on the channel, and the last video had a pretty good response from the audience. And yeah, because you know your stuff, man. And as I mentioned before we start the video, it's good to see that dedication that you're giving to, you know, to the Helium 10, the Helium 10 users, and you provide us with great experience. Myself as a user of Helium 10, as a seller on Amazon, and also as an affiliate. Thank you for that, man. And yeah, I would be happy if you could share some hacks, tricks for product research for us. It's 2021. I mean, in like 2 days, what is like 30s of December today. Yeah.
Yeah, I can't believe it. I think nobody is sad to see this year finish though. Pretty sure.
Probably, man. Probably I would say that it's so. It was a good year as well. Many good things happened, but it was surprisingly also maybe not the best year in terms of many things that happened. Yeah.
But I wanted to talk a little bit about some product research, because I think that's what is maybe one of the more sexy parts, right, of Amazon. And at least for me, it's so fun to look for product opportunity. Just the, even if I don't find something right away, just the process of discovering things that people are searching for. And not only did I not know it, but I didn't even know it exists. And these are English words. You know, I'm living in America and people are searching for this in this country, in my language. And there are words every time I do this. And I'm like, I have never heard of this before. And that's the beauty about Amazon. You know, we talked about the Project X that we did on Helium 10. And I had no idea that people love a shelf that's shaped like a coffin. Like that just like blows my mind. And we found that opportunity. And I'm looking here at the numbers. And even though we were out of stock almost 3 months this year, we sold like almost $200,000 of this product. There are now thousands of homes in America that somewhere in their wall, they have a shelf that looks like a coffin. And if that doesn't just like make you go crazy, then I don't know what's going to make you go crazy. But that shows you just the kind of opportunity there is on Amazon. You can find the most strange thing, and there are thousands of people who want to pay you for it, and you can make money. And that's what Amazon is.
Yeah, man, that's true. The process of research is really, it's fun, man, as you mentioned, because you get to find weird things sometimes and funny things and things you wouldn't really expect that even exist. And sometimes, as you mentioned, like you're an American, right? You know English pretty well. And then you find stuff that you didn't know existed before you were doing all these product research, you know, things. But eventually these things can sell. You know, we're sellers. We want to make money, you know, provide good products as well. But yeah, and then we can take the opportunity and sell the stuff as well.
Yep. Right? Yep. So if it's all right, I wanted to share with you some of my best kind of like strategies that I think that not many people are using, because they're newer features, but it's a way that I use in order to find opportunities. Does that sound good?
Yeah, man. I think people who are watching also are pretty excited. If they are, would like to get a like for this. It helps the algorithm, and this way you can understand if the actual good stuff or not. So yeah, go ahead, man. Yep, thank you.
In Amazon, we call it search, find, buy. On YouTube, search, find, like. I think we
right. Worked right, right? Search, find, like, and comment, if you will, as well.
There we go. And comment. Yeah. S-F-L-C. I guess search, find, like, comment. All right. Anyways. All right. So let me share my screen. You can see my Helium 10 screen.
All right. There it is.
And then again, here's what I was saying. You know, this is the actual Project X account, and you could see the sales so far this year over $200,000. Like I wasn't making those numbers up. This is real numbers. But the tool that is the best for looking for product research is Blackbox. And I like looking right here in the keywords. So it's kind of funny. To look for a product, I don't look for a product. I look for the keywords. So I'm going to go to keywords. And I don't personally, everybody can do their own thing. That's the beauty about Blackbox, is you put your own factors of whatever you like. But me personally, I don't like looking for the huge search volume, you know, like 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. That's great. If you want to do that, fine. I like, they talk about, there's a phrase in English, there's riches in the niches. All right. So I like looking for the like really strange things to discover, coffin shelves and other things. So I'm just going to put here maybe minimum 2,000 and let's just go to 4,000. All right. This is just a starting point. This is not a magic number. So everybody don't just copy exactly what I'm doing. Otherwise, everybody's going to look at the same thing. So pick your own numbers here. One thing I want to do is like an average price. Let's do minimum maybe $15, maximum 50. And this just makes it so that it doesn't mean that there's not going to be any products that show up over 50 or under 15, but this is just taking the average. I don't want the average to be $100 or something, because I think a lot of us, we can't afford to invest in a product that retails for $100 because of minimum order quantities and things like that. Another thing I like to do here is put minimum words too, because there's a lot of, you know, good keywords that only have one keyword, but I want keywords that people use to buy more. And in my experience, keywords that are only one word sometimes is not for buying, like kitchen or bathroom. Exactly. Like nobody types that and then buys something. They're just like trying to browse, you know? So if it's kitchen countertop utensil, hey, that's something that people can maybe buy, or bathroom ornament or something like that. All right. Speaking of ornament, it's still a week or two from Christmas time. So I don't want a lot of the Christmas keywords to come up. So right off the bat, I'm going to say, hey, don't show me anything that says Christmas, Xmas, ornament, ornaments. I'm sure there's other keywords that come up, but let's just get rid of those. Nowadays, anything to do with the home, it seems like, is very trending. So I'm going to, again, you guys pick whatever you want. I'm just doing something for this example here. Let's go ahead and do a home and kitchen and dining, and patio. So these three are a lot of things in the house. I could have done sports, pet supplies, home improvement, but let's just pick three for now. And now, normally, in most of my videos, we talk about using review count up here, maybe revenue. This time I'm going to use some newer filters. So the one that I like to do is competitor revenue and competitor review. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, maybe I want to see some listings where some of the top 10 that show up on this keyword have some certain kind of metric. So I'm going to say, maybe at least five of the first top 10 products have estimated sales of more than $2,500. All right. I mean, I could have picked different numbers here, but let's just start there. And then competitor reviews of those top 10 that show up on the page one of the keyword, I would like to see maybe more than, or at least six. Let's just, again, I'm picking random numbers. You guys pick what you want. I want at least six out of the first top 10 to have less than 150 reviews. So it gives me an idea that maybe it's a newer trend, or the competition is not yet that established, right? Let's just go ahead and start with this, and let's see what comes up, all right?
All right.
All right. Here we go. Already. I don't know what is this. bourbon. I know what bourbon is. That's alcohol.
What is that? Yeah, bourbon, alcohol. Yeah, right.
And then candle is a candle. But what is a bourbon candle? I mean, is that literally the candle made from the alcohol?
Let's see, man.
I have no idea what this is. I guess so. Interesting. See, like this is a certain kind of smell, maybe of candle.
Right.
Interesting. But anyways, why did this show up? You could see products here on the page one is very few reviews, right? Yeah. Very few reviews, right? All right. So there's something. We just discovered something new. Chocolate sphere mold. Maybe that's has to do with like something like a cookie cutter or something, or some kind of round. I don't know. Let's take a look. Almost looks like egg tray.
Yeah, right.
Like Project X. Okay. So, I mean, this might be already too late. You know, we see some bestsellers already but we can see why it came up. There's a number of listings here that have less than 150 reviews and a number that have more. Okay. I didn't know there was a such thing as that. Let's keep going. Funny boss gifts. That's kind of funny. Here, guys, don't do just because people are searching for it. This is a dangerous, don't do drug related keywords. All right. Not that great.
Yeah.
Beer tasting glasses. That sounds like it would be a good thing. Let's see. Heat. Wow. All right. Now this is what we call a long tail keyword. This is about as specific as you can get. I mean, if I am searching this kind of keyword, I'm really looking for something specific. Now, I have no idea what is this, but look at this. There are 4,000 people who know what this is and they are searching for it. Let's take a look at what this looks like. Oh, okay. I think I know. I have an idea of this. But look at this. This is kind of crazy. 4,000 people searching for this.
Oh, yeah. I know.
Amazon's choice is only 90 reviews and only 4 stars. All right.
Nice.
Page one, position three, only 7 reviews. Page one, position four. Look at this. 0 reviews. And this is page one, position four on a keyword that is searched for almost 4,000 times. This is so difficult to find. And if we want to dig a little bit deeper, we could use, you know, the Helium 10 X-ray tool. And then we can say, all right, what is happening here on page one for this keyword? All right, what are some of these products here generating in sales? And we could see a few of them. There's only one really dominating. This first one here is selling maybe 20 units a day. All right. So these other ones looks like brand new products that barely started selling. So it would be pretty easy to take away to kind of like steal the sales from these other products. All right. So there's another opportunity. Let's just keep going really quick here. I mean, I'm just finding a lot of strange things here. Large pine cones, tin cans, ceiling curtain track. I think I know what that is, but I can't believe that there's 4,000 people who are searching for that ceiling curtain track. Let's just like skip to page 7 here. Coffee cup holder wall mounted. Again, a very specific keyword. And now that I see this, it's like it makes sense to me. Okay, I kind of can picture this, but let's just take a look at how it looks on Amazon. Yes. All right. This is what I thought it was. Something that goes up on the wall and you can hang your coffee cups. All right. And then we could see here that this one here is on page one. This is not, well, what's wrong with this image right here?
Well, which one? On the 16?
This one here in the middle of the screen. The Home is Joy one. This one right here. Can you see it?
Oh, this one. You mean that it's like not on a white background? Or
yeah, exactly. So like here's on page one. And they could probably have their listing suspended anytime because this is not even Amazon compliant. You know, usually big keywords and big sellers, you don't see that, but that is kind of like an indication that these sellers here in this niche is kind of rookies, you know, like they're not, I mean, same thing right here. Here's another one. This is not a white background. So right here, 2 out of the top 8 listings don't even have the white background. So this is what I'm talking about when I say that, you know, people, it doesn't matter. We're talking 2020, 2021. This took us less than 10 minutes. We found like 5, 6, 7 different potential product opportunities. There's still opportunity out there. You just have to find it.
Bradley, thank you for sharing this cool method with the black box. I didn't even use these parameters yet, the one that you've used in the end. Yep. I think that's new. I didn't know that. It's going to be nice to test out. I have a question for you, man.
Sure.
So, right. So we can use these cool methods and we see a lot of different products that pop up. But what would you look at as maybe for 2021 or 2020, it doesn't matter really, like metrics that you would say, all right, this seems good to me. Like when you found the, you know, the egg tray or the, you know, the coffin with your project with Tim, what are the things that you're most looking at? Like lower amount of reviews on page one or, you know what I mean? Like maybe you can give us some ideas here.
Some of my things we talked about in the Maldives honeymoon launch is actually not just about your launch, but in the product research phase. Yeah. So as I'm looking for these product research, what I love to look for is if I search for a keyword, like we just searched for, I forgot, coffee cup holder wall mounted or what was some of the other one? Heat diffuser for glass or whatever, is I like to check on page one, how many listings have that exact keyword in the title. Mm-hmm. You know, we always use the example collagen peptides. Like if you go to collagen peptides and you check page one, more than half, if not 75% of the listings, they all have in their title collagen peptides. So even regardless of sales, that makes it that much harder to get to page one when everybody has that title. When we first found the coffin shelf, there was only one listing in the entire page one that had coffin shelf in the title. There was actually only one listing that was a coffin shelf. Yeah. But when you can find keywords that have 3,000, 4,000, 10,000 searches, but only 4 or 5 products on page one even have that word in the title, that gets me excited. So that's one of the things that I like to look for.
I see, man. That's pretty cool tip for the audience. So for the viewers, I'll say also we have coupon codes for those who would like to try and use Helium 10 for product research, for keyword optimization, for whatnot, really. It's really one of the biggest all-in-one tools at the moment. So you can use either this code, which is VOVA50, VOVA50 is going to appear on the screen. This will give you 50% off your first month on Helium 10. Or you can use VOVA10, which will give you like 10% off every month while you're a user of Helium 10. These also work for the annual plan, so you can see if you can score a discount there. And hopefully this helps you out. And Bradley, man, thank you for your time today. Really nice stuff. I think for people who are searching for products, for veterans or newbies, is going to be very helpful, man. And really appreciate your time, and you're always welcome here. And if you need anything from me as well, man, you're always welcome to reach out. Really appreciate your time, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it. And I always love doing videos with you. You have a great audience. And so hope we inspired somebody to maybe go find their product. So 2021 can make a lot of money and then go to the Maldives for your honeymoon if you get married.
Yeah, right, man. Sounds good. And thank you again, man. Thank you.